Welcome to our short demonstration of our process mining template for Power BI. Today we want to have a look at the different pages that are included into the template, the different visuals, and some of the main functionalities based on our order to cache demo set that I've set up here. Starting with the overview page, we can see the main component right in the middle, our process analyzer. So the visual really displaying the processes, how they have been performed. Looking at the process here, we can see that we have two main process variants. If I select them, we can see the two variants here. We see that we have one path with inquiry, quotations, order confirmations, and payment shipment posts in the end. And then the other one, we have orders, call of orders, and call of confirmations here. Now, these two process variants are the main variants, the one that the company expected that they have within their order to cache process. As we see, we definitely have more. I mean, this is a demo data set, but we still have more than these two variants. And within the process analyzer, we are able to display all of them without creating filters on the on the report itself. And we see this is only within the process analyzer visual. So showing the top 10 variants here, which will give us this process view. When it comes to the information that we can show on the process analyzer, we are as flexible as in any other visual in Power BI. Now we can show durations, we can show frequencies, we can show the costs, we can show amount of resources, whatever information we have from the data model, we can show on the visual and switch through them dynamically based on what we currently want to see. So looking at the frequencies, for example, would give us this view while looking at the average of duration will give us this view based on the main KPI or PPI that we are showing on an edge. What we also see on the activities here are these little boxes. Now these little boxes here tell us that this activity is part of an activity group. We also see is that we have the name and we have the activity group name. So the call of order is part of the call of process, or for example, the order confirmation is part of the order process. And we see inquiry here also part of the order process. So what we are able to do is we can build up multiple hierarchies saying we don't want to see the full complexity of the process. Maybe at the first analysis step, we want to see the first level, the first grouping. So that's what we've set up here. We only have two hierarchies. We are able to build as much hierarchies as we like. So if we want to switch to the other hierarchy, we can do that by using the toggle button here. If we have multiple hierarchies, this will be a list and not a toggle. And we see that this will show us the grouped activities. Now we now see the order process, for example, which has the detailed activities, inquiry, quotation, order, and order confirmation. And if we show 100% of all grouped variants, generally only six, and we are still looking at the same 1600 cases, this is the process that we are looking at. Much less complex, better overview, and maybe you want to go ahead with this view and create filters. So say, okay, we only care about processes that have this others group here, filter for them. And afterwards we will get the result with 52 cases remaining. And now we can go back to the detailed view, clicking the toggle button here, and then we jump back to all activities, all variants that are currently selected, but with the full activity list here. So this is one option to create multiple, or this is one hierarchy. Like I said, we can have multiple ones. And of course, within this one, we can still filter based on these variants here. And now we have two filters applied to the whole report, being the one on the first level and the one on the second level of the hierarchy. If we jump to the rework page here, we see that because of the transformation that we are doing, we of course are putting in information into the data model that we can directly get from the process data, from the event log data. So you can combine all the information that we have for your processes with your data that you have within your company to really get everything from the BI system. And everything you see here, all this information, everything is in the data model. You can put it in all kinds of visuals, whatever visual you like. And so the amount of loops per activity, per variant, per case ID, everything here is in the data model. So you can use it in some sort of metrics. You can use it in the process analyzer, short on activities, and even use it as filters up here to say you only want to see cases with loops, for example. Then this one here will only show all the cases with loops. And we can also say we only want to see cases with self loops. And then this one here will do. And so, for example, the auto confirmation here has a self loop because an auto confirmation has been done after 20 minutes of the first auto confirmation. Creating a little bit more complex filters based on specific order of activity, specific subprocess within the process analyzer might be a bit of a hard task, a little bit of a challenge. So that's why we have our events filter here, which can be used to create filters based on a dynamic BPMN model. Now there's also our target process, I will show you that later on, which is based on directly imported BPMN models, but this one here you can use for dynamic BPMN filters. So let's assume we want to see everything that has an inquiry first. So it starts with an inquiry, and it also has maintenance at any point afterwards, so indirectly followed. And it also should have a payment, or, and that's something we might want to create as a or here. So if it does not have maintenance, or it either has maintenance or it should be call of order. I mean, this one here doesn't make sense. Let me switch it. So we either have an inquiry with maintenance anywhere followed, maybe also directly inquiry, and or we have the call of order process. And so now if we look at path with inquiry, so all of these paths here with inquiry, they're always going to have maintenance included. These are the steps for this path, and then we have the other path here. Also creating a little bit more complex filters with BPMN rules can be applied here. You can also exclude them, or say I want to have parallel gateways, so everything in here should be matched and everything in here, and only after finishing all of these tasks it will go to the next level after the parallel gateway. All right, removing the filter and jumping to our root cause analyzer. So let's say we want to see the main influence factors for loops within the process. And so we select loops here, we see the cases with loops, and I toggle the root cause analyzer. Now then here we have information like count of activities, last activities, unique variants, stuff like that. It's a very generic information, but you can put in every kind of information that you have in your data model. So factories, products, locations, whatever you have, you can put it in here and we'll show you the main influence factors for the question that you're asking by creating filters, selections on the current page. Jumping to automation, this is just a quick show. Yeah, we have the ability to load information about automation in your event log directly into our templates, display them on activities, build up color scales based on the automation rates, for example. And then if you have the costs of your activities, combine them with the automation rate, build up some what if analysis. What if we have activities that are being more automated or less automated? How will this change the lead times? How will this change the costs? So yes, this is possible as well. So next up, our benchmarking page. Again, we set this up with very generic data. We only have information about the years and if the variant is unique or not. We don't have anything like products, plants, where you can combine this. But in general, it's been set up that everything on the left side will be one group. So we can set a filter here, looking at maybe cases that have started in 2016. And then on the right side, we maybe want to look at all the cases in 2017. And then we can compare these two with all kinds of additional information here, combine them with different product categories, different regions, and really look into everything here, anything there. Maybe we also want to see call of orders. So then we are going to filter within the graph and only look at the call of order process in 2016 compared to the call of order process in 2017. Then the lead times page. One visual here that I want to talk about is our lead times analyzer, which can be used to have a closer look at lead times between activities that are not directly followed. Because if we want to know how long does it take from quotation to order on average, it will tell us by looking at the graph, it seems 3 days, 2 hours. That's not a problem. But if we want to know how long does it take from order to shipment, for example, then calculating all of this different durations here, it's not really something we can do. And we only have like 23 process variants. So that's why we have the lead times analyzer. If I select the order here and the shipment as the end activity here, we will get the result as the average duration up here. So it's 1 month, 3 weeks. And what we also get is a grouping based on specific duration groups. Yeah, so we see that we have 800 cases in a group of 4 months. Then we have two groups of 3 days, 3 days, 1 hour, 3 days, 8 hours. These are different groups that are also being shown here. We can also just use it as a small visual with only the duration without the bar chart here. That's also possible. If we then want to have a closer look at all the cases and not have this aggregated view that we have in the process analyzer, we want to have a closer look at specific cases. We can jump, for example, with the filter from a different page to our cases page here, where we then see all the cases line up. And we see this is case 20, 23. It's not on a variant level. Yeah, it's on a case level. And for every activity here, for every case, we now have all the information that we want to put in there. Here we see, in this case here, we have information if this activity is rework or not, if it was automated. You can also have stuff like what resource were put in, what is the cost for this exact activity in this case. And then if we scroll through, we see here, for example, the shipment activity. This one was one that has been performed a second time within the case 87. So this has the rework flag set to one. So like I said, and again, all kind of information that you have within your report, you can put into the visual. It's as flexible as any other visual as well. Then on the last page, we have set up our target process. Like I said in the beginning, or in the rework page, we can have a filter based on BPMN rules being created dynamically by users within the report using the events filter. But if we have a target process or multiple target processes that we want to use coming from any sort of BPMN tool or directly being created in Power BI in the report, we can load that into our data model and use that, for example, within the process analyzer. And that's what we've set up here. We see that we have the target process enabled. In our demo here, the top two process variants are our target processes. And so that's why everything here has is displaying in green. So in case this one's conformant with our target processes. If we, for example, say the top five variants here, we see that these activities are deviating from it. Yeah, these paths here are deviating, colored in a different way. And of course, we can create filters for that target process, saying we only care about cases that are excluding or deviating from it. And then these are all the cases, 356 cases that are deviating from it at one point. Of course, what we can also do is combine this with the benchmarking page, combine this with the root cause analyzer to really tell us what are, for example, the main influences for cases deviating from the target process, or showing what are the differences in when everything goes well, everything goes like the target process, when it deviates from it, and really get the information that we want to, yeah, maybe change the target process because it's not up to date, or change how the people within our organization are performing the processes to get back to the desired processes. Yeah, this has been a short demo of what we are capable of, what the Power BI solution is capable of. Of course, there are many, many more features that we could dive into deeper. But that's a quick overview. And as always, if you have any questions or like to see more, just get in touch with us and we are happy to provide you with an individual demo, with an individual test license so that you can test it yourself.